Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, myself Arpita Paul, and in my today's tutorial I will tell you how to use array elements in Java. So let's start the video. So we have a program here to accept 5 elements in an array and print only the sum of even elements. Okay, so basically we will input 5 elements and we will print only sum of even elements. Okay, so let's start the writing part. So as usual, in the first line we will import the util package because we will use scanner class to take input. Then we will declare our class here. Then we will use our main method. Then within the main method we will create the scanner class object by writing scanner space sc equals to new scanner system dot in. Then in the next line we will declare the array, we will initialize the array size also. Okay, so how to do that? First we will write the data type, which is here int, then the array name arr, okay, and then the third bracket we will provide to signify this is an array element. Then after equals to we will write new, then again the data type and the size of the array. As it was told to us to take 5 elements in the array, we are writing here 5. Okay, so this arr array will occupy 5 memory for 5 elements. Okay, so let me show you how it will look like in memory. This is how it will look like in memory. Okay, so after that we are declaring one variable s. Okay, this variable we are declaring to store the sum of the elements, okay, which is integer type, and we are initializing the value of s with 0. Okay, so the value of s is initialized with 0. Then here we have added one statement part, that is system.out.println enter all the elements. Okay, so we will enter the elements in the array. So for that we are using the for loop. Here we are writing int I equals to 0, separating with semicolon I less than 5, then separating with semicolon we are writing I plus plus. If your basic concept about array is not clear, then you should go through my previous videos, and the video links are given in the description box. So the initial value of I is 0, then it will check 0 less than 5, yes, it will get inside. Then the first element will be entered at arr of I, that means in the 0th position. Okay, so here in the 0th position, say 10 is entered. Now after that it will come to the if statement for checking. So arr of I, so the current value of I is 0, so whatever value is in the 0th position that will be checked. So here we have 10, so it will check 10 mod 2 equals to 0. Okay, so we are checking it is an even element or odd. So 10 is of course divisible by 2, so it is an even number, so it will get inside, then it will calculate the sum. For that it will do s equals to s plus arr of I. So the current value of s is 0, we have initialized it with 0, then plus the current value of the array is 10. So 0 plus 10, the sum will become 10. Now after getting out of the if statement, it will increment the value of I, then it will be 1. So 1 less than 5, yes, it will get inside. So the next element will be entered in the first index. Okay, say it is 50, so again it will go to the if statement for checking. So arr of 1 mod 2 equals to 0. So we have 15 in first index, so 15 mod 2 equals to 0. No, it will not satisfy, so it will not get inside the if statement. It will directly go to the increment part, and the value of I will be now 2. So it will check 2 less than 5, yes, it will get inside. So next element will be entered in the second index, and say it is 20. So again, next value will be checked, 20 mod 2 equals to 0. Yes, it is satisfying, then it will get inside, and then it will calculate the sum. S equals to the previous value of S plus the current element of the array. So the previous value of sum was 10 plus the current element of the array is 20. So 10 plus 20 becomes 30. Okay, now after calculating the sum, it will come out of the if statement and it will go to the increment part. So the value of I will be 3 now. 3 less than 5, yes. So the next element will be entered in the third index of the array. Say it is 25. So again it will check 25 mod 2 equals to 0? No, so it will not get inside the if statement. It will directly go to the increment part. The value of I will be 4. So 4 less than 5, yes. So again it will get inside and the next element will be entered in the index 4. And say it is 30. So it will check again 30 mod 2 equals to 0. Yes, it is satisfying. So it will get inside and it will calculate the sum. Then sum will be the previous value of s was 30 plus the current element in the array is 30. So 30 plus 30 becomes 60. Okay. Now again after coming out of the if statement, the value of I will be incremented and it will be 5. So 5 less than 5? No. So it will come out of the loop. Okay. So after coming out of the loop, we will print the total sum. For that we are writing system.out.println sum of all even elements is equals to pluses. So the final value of s is 60. This is the last value of s and this will be printed here. Okay. Do remember, always print the sum outside the loop. Why? Because we want the total sum, not the intermediate value. If we are printing this statement inside the loop, then all intermediate values will be printed. 10, 30, 60, everything will be printed. But here it was told to print the sum of only even elements. Okay. So that is why we have printed the statement outside of the loop to get the total sum. Okay. Now let me show you the output. So compile the program. You can see class compiled, no syntax error. So right click on the class, click on void main. Okay. So here, enter all the elements. So I am entering the values 10, 15, 20, 25 and 30. So you can see here all the same elements I have entered 10, 15, 20, 25 and 30 and the total sum is 60. Okay. So this is how we can easily take input and we can use array elements in our program. So thank you everyone. Like and share the video and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you.